Okay, welcome to the modernist section of this walk. There are four modernist buildings that we've referenced in this walk. We have the North York Board of Education building on the right here, the Toronto Centre for the Arts, formerly the Ford Centre. We have the Civic Centre over here, the Civic Building, and then we have the library where we started and where we will end. The North York Board of Education, it's now the Toronto Board of Education. When there was amalgamation in 1998, North York actually became the administrative center for the whole city. The modernist building, as I say, was opened in 1970. The board offices were designed by the Toronto architectural firm of Mathers and Holdenby in what's known as the brutalist style. And I think you can see that it's pretty different than some of the other buildings around. It really thrusts itself upon you. It's blocky. It's dramatic. It's darker in color. It has anodized aluminum, which is quite unusual. The firm of Mathers and Holdenby also designed the Robarts Library downtown at the University of Toronto, which everybody thinks of as the sort of primary brutalist building in the city. A borough of North York purchased the land. They purchased over 18 acres from the Toronto Burial Grounds for $2.3 million in 1967. North York planned to develop a civic center, but the first thing to be developed was the North York Board. They took off 4 acres and gave that to the North York Board of Education. And in fact, it was a good example of the municipalities and the Board of Education working together. There's a quote from the Reeve at the time the site was chosen deliberately in order that two municipal jurisdictions, the Board of Ed and the Borough of North York, may be in close proximity. So there was that sense of establishing North York as a coordinated, integrated municipality. And of course, that didn't last for very long, but amalgamation came later. In terms of heritage, the building of the four, it is listed on the City of Toronto's inventory of heritage properties, which is a good thing. Over then on my left, on your right, is the Toronto Centre for the Arts. Otherwise known as North York Performing Arts Centre, was its former name. And that was built by Zeidler Roberts. Eberhard Zeidler is a well-known Toronto firm that did a number of concert facilities across North America. They did one down in West Palm Beach and the Mississauga Centre for the Arts. The difference about this building is that when it was designed, it was actually intended to serve the whole city right at the beginning. Like the other ones, you know, were for North York as its own municipality. But they wanted to make North York, wanted people from everywhere to come to North York, to come to the theater. And actually for a while that worked. Some of you may recall going to see Showboat here when it first opened. But, you know, bad things happened, and unfortunately, Garth Drabinsky, his firm, Live Ent, was the manager of the property, and as you know, he ran into some problems. So eventually, they went bankrupt in 1998. The City of Toronto assumed control and renamed the Toronto Centre for the Arts in 2000. Then Aubrey Dan launched DanCard Productions in 2007, but in 2012, this April, it was announced that after 5 years of presenting Broadway shows, the company would not be mounting the 2013 season. Inside, there are three performance venues. The main one is a 1,000-seat recital hall. When it was opened, it was probably the best in the city. Martin Nelman, who writes for the Toronto Star, he said at the time, "It's a priceless jewel with superb acoustics and the best place in Toronto to hear music.
I'm just going to point out, if you look at the top, you'll see the carillon, the bells, which is on the tallest building in the North York City Center, and that broke every rule as far as height went. It even went beyond what North York allowed, well beyond. Anyways, and the carillon, which I always call Mel's Bells.
Yes.
And one more thing of interest, when we were standing at the corner of Beecroft, you could see the obelisk, as it were. There's actually a wonderful view standing over at Yonge. It's an unrestricted view from Yonge Street across, right the way across there. And that view has been protected. It's going to be protected,
going to be protected
in the new official plan, which will come to council in a year or so. So as residents of North York, you might want to watch for that.